Well, Wacko Fish here for another BMS video, and in this video we're going to look at GBU39's STB bombs. These are what's called on-powered glide bombs with internal navigation. Essentially they are GPS bombs, and they're small with high explosives, so we can carry 8 of them. They got a fantastic standoff range, so they're fire and forget, but they do need pre-assigned targets. They can be fired in visual mode, but it kind of defeats the purpose since they're designed to be gliding and standing off from long distance, so it's going to be hard to get a target visually unless you're close enough to do it. So with that in mind, we're going to demonstrate them in pre-assigned target mode only, and we've got a set of pre-assigned targets from 99 down to 91. And they're close to steer point 4, which is on the range, the training range on Sicily. And I focused in on a group of UEs and MiGs to target. So I'm going to push to our steer 4, and I'm going to roll onto that bearing. Now we're currently 28 miles from steer 4, so we'll put us in autopilot mode, and then we're going to configure the weapons for deployment. So roll out there into autopilot mode and push our speed up a little bit. Okay, so air to ground mode, SMS page, and power on with OSB 7. We'll change HSD to the left side. Now we can see we have 8 GBU39s. Master arm to on and master external lights to off.
3 in position.
So we're pretty much fenced and ready to go. And we can see actually we have our release cue already, even though we're 21 miles away. So we can release our weapons now, but I'm going to do a little bit more configuring. On the control page from OSB 5, you can see there's two options there. There is an azimuth angle, and there is an ROB, which is range on bearing. And these are designed to be able to ensure that the weapons come in from a certain direction outside a particular distance. The azimuth angle is relative to magnetic north, so we wanted to send the weapon in from the west, or from the east for instance, we'd be setting that angle to 270, and we wanted it to be at that angle within 10 miles, we'd set the ROB for 10 miles. While you can change the numbers here, I don't believe it's working in 436, it doesn't have any impact, so we're going to go back to the main page and then look at OSB 19, which allows us to configure single or a paired release. And they can be either side by side or front to back. So I'm going to do front to back, and I'm going to put a moderate distance between them of 100 feet. But that's going to essentially make them work as if they're almost a single pair of bombs. Now it's important when you're rippling, and I'm going to ripple now, that you hold the button down. And before I do that, I need to set our target point and our steer point. So it's ICP. 4 followed by 99 and enter, and then finally just adjust my position on that TMS up. Designates the target, and then I'm going to hold the ripple down, and you can hear the two releasing. So I'm going to go back to steer point 98 and hold them down again. I'm back to 97, TMS up, and hold them down again. 96, and we're just almost running out of time here now. And I'm going to hold them down again. So you can see the two off the rails there. And now we look at them on the way in. You can see them heading towards the target area. We're targeting those Hueys there. Yeah, you can see some in already. And they look like pretty decent hits. Just going to come out of autopilot now and let's drop down and have a quick look.
Altitude.
And we can see that was pretty much where I had assigned the targets, which was on the UEs and those MiGs in the center of the field. So, I hope you found this useful. And feel free to like, dislike, subscribe and comment. And until the next time, this is Fish Out. And thank you for watching.